Hi, this is Chris with a quick FrameForge tip video. I'm going to share some helpful tips and info for working with light source props like this one on screen. Light sources in FrameForge are special objects, be they free-floating light sources or models of real-world lighting instruments. Take this model of a 1K studio light with stand, for example. Notice that you have special lighting controls like the aim at or brightness intensity that do not exist for other objects. You want to access the normal controls, such as spin, tilt, scale, and pose. Use the control key if you're a Windows user. Use the option key if you're a Mac user. These barn doors attached to this light prop are also poseable. You can manipulate them like you would any hinged object in FrameForge. You could double-click the light source to load it into the green room and change the pose of these individual barn doors. But if you do it this way, you won't be able to see the effect on the lighting until after you exit the green room. A more pragmatic approach would be to pose those barn doors on set so that you can immediately see how those changes affect the illumination of your scene. In order to do that, use the control or option key, depending on your OS, to view the object's normal controls and click the pose orb. When you do so, you will see all the available hinges for this light source listed on the left side of the screen. You're also in a special pose mode, which means that clicking and dragging in the live view results in the view dawdling towards or away from the object, as well as spinning around it. You can also pan and tilt around the object by holding the control or option key, depending on your OS again, while click-dragging your mouse pointer in the live view. To change the object's pose, click the hinge you wish to pose from the posing menu on the left and then click drag this slider. That's really it. When you're done, you can exit the pose mode by clicking this X to exit the pose menu, or you can simply click on any blank spot of the live view set. You'll be returned to the view from the camera you were previously working with. Thanks for watching. I'll talk to you again in another video.